Hi everyone, Jeanette with Beeble Vintage Designs. I wanted to show you how I did this center today. Very easy. And I'll show you the colors that I used as well. So the list of items that you'll need is, I have photo paper here that I cut into quarters. I used pitch black, sunshine yellow, cranberry, and Valencia. I also have a black and a white Posca pen. The tips are 0.7. I also have a white gel pen and the Ranger air blower. All right, so the first thing I did was I put down some cranberry on my photo paper. Use a little micro brush to move it around a little bit. And then dry it. Then I'm putting Valencia on the outside of that ring. Then we're going to dry that. Don't worry if it blends together. That's okay. Then the next color is sunshine yellow. Putting that in between. And then I put a drop of pitch black in the center. And I'm going to move it around a little bit with my micro brush and dry it. Let me refill my alcohol because we use a lot of it for these flowers. The more alcohol you use, the wider your petals will be. And I'm going to have a paper towel to blot off the ends of the paper. All right. So I'm putting down a large circle of alcohol. And then I'm using my blower to blow out the petal and using the paper towel to blot the edge of the paper. With the excess alcohol in it. Make sure it's completely dry. This is a great color combination. It looks like fire. So the closer you blow with this tool, the larger your petals become. I said this before in another video, I was very skeptical when I bought this, but my compressor was broken and I was waiting for the new one to be delivered, and I needed to make some flowers, so I thought I'd give it a try, and I was very pleasantly surprised. I think it works great. And if you work on tile, I find this works better on tile than the airbrush. Where's that tile? I don't know where it is, but I did a tile in a video the other day, a couple of days back, and it came out so great. Take a look at that video, see what I mean. This is so pretty. Okay, got one more petal, I believe, right here. And then we can get to the center. Not sure what happened here. I don't like it, so I'm going to blow another petal over it. Now, of course, I have to make another one here. Look how easy it is to create the petals with this tool. And you can just keep going over it until you get what you like. Gives you such nice texture also to your petals. All right, I'm going to leave it like that. And now I'm going to use the pitch black to darken the center a little bit. I'm just going to put a little drop on my brush. I'll dry it. And dry it a little bit more. Now I'm going to take my black Posca pen, shake it up, and I'm just going to pump in first. Pump it. There you go. And now I'm just going to make lines. I'm going to make them come out in all different directions. I want them to cross each other. I don't think my ink is dry enough. That's why I'm having such issues with the Posca pen. I think we're going to do it. I want to make sure that this is completely dry. I see some spots that I just want to darken a little bit. And hopefully that's dry enough. I'm going to take my gel pen and I'm going to do a couple of lines. Because of the pitch black underneath, they will turn kind of purpley. And then I'm taking the black Posca pen and I'm just drawing little tips to some of these little hairs that I drew on there. Very small tips, don't make them too big. And not every single little hair has to have a tip. Then I took the white Posca pen. And I did a little bit of these as well. Then I'm want to darken the center a little bit more, so. I'm just drawing some more lines with the black. And there you go. Now they look a little bit different. This is the one I just did. And this is the one I did earlier. But they both look really pretty. Very easy to do using the Posca pens. Posca pens are definitely a must-have. I recommend them in the 0.7 tip. If you're only buying black and white, buy the 0.7. They're great for outlining and doing paintings like this. You saw me do this one yesterday. And the larger tip ones are wonderful for larger paintings and for embellishing, as I did in this painting yesterday. But if you're only going to get two colors, because they are expensive, I would recommend to get the black and the white in the 0.7 tip. All right, everyone, I hope you enjoyed that and found it helpful. Let me know if you have any questions. Enjoy what's left of Sunday. Also, I wanted to remind you to check out my Facebook page, because I've been doing some Facebook Live on there and I don't want you to miss it. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Enjoy the rest of Sunday. Bye.